Hello, in this video, we will see the physiology of muscle contraction. We will see the excitation contraction coupling and then myosin cross bridge cycle that ultimately produces contraction. We have seen the relevant anatomy in detail in a separate video. Though we will be quickly revising it here, it's highly recommended that you watch it first if you haven't already. On that note, let's get started with a quick revision of the anatomy. A muscle cell contains myofibrils, transverse tubules, and sarcoplasmic reticulum. Myofibrils are cylindrical and arranged parallelly. Each myofibril in turn is a chain of regularly repeating units called sarcomere. Sarcomeres contain thin filaments and thick filaments. Thin filaments consist of actin, tropomyosin, and troponin. Filamentous actin makes the backbone of the thin filament. Tropomyosin and troponin are regulatory actin binding proteins. Under the resting condition, the tropomyosin covers active sites on actin molecules. So that was thin filament. Thick filaments interdigitate with thin filaments. They consist of many myosin II molecules. Myosin has a tail where all the myosin molecules are connected and a crossbridge region that extends out. Crossbridge has a globular head and arm. So these are microfibrils. Now surrounding the myofibrils is T-tubule sarcoplasmic reticulum system. T-tubules are invaginations of plasma membrane. And sarcoplasmic reticulum is a special type of endoplasmic reticulum. This is a longitudinal cut section. These are T-tubules. The sarcoplasmic reticulum is made up of longitudinal tubules that make the most of the area and terminal cisternae that are close to T-tubules. This assembly of T-tubule in the middle and two neighboring terminal cisternae is called triad junction. This was all inside the cell. On the cell membrane, we have neuromuscular junction having presynaptic nerve terminal and postsynaptic membrane, which is basically muscle plasma membrane. This was all the anatomy. Now let's see how muscle contracts. First of all, the stimulus for contraction comes along a nerve and reaches the neuromuscular junction. After all the events of neuromuscular transmission, which are already covered in a separate video, an action potential is generated at the postsynaptic membrane. The action potential spreads along the membrane. Along T-tubules, it penetrates deeper into the muscle cell. Now let's go to the triad junction where the next magic happens. As we have seen, the action potential passes through the T-tubules. Now here we have L type of calcium channels on the membrane of T-tubules. Action potential causes them to open. This causes an influx of calcium from T-tubules into the cell. See, the T-tubules are invaginations from cell membrane. So the fluid inside is in fact extracellular fluid and the calcium entering through these channels is extracellular calcium. Now these calcium channels make physical contact with calcium release channels on sarcoplasmic reticulum. So the opening of L type of calcium channels mechanically opens calcium release channels also. This causes diffusion of calcium from lumen of sarcoplasmic reticulum into the sarcoplasm. Thus this calcium is coming from cell's own storage in sarcoplasmic reticulum. In a nutshell, action potential causes calcium entry from extracellular fluid as well as sarcoplasmic reticulum and increases cytosolic calcium concentration. Now the calcium spreads into the sarcomere. At present, the tropomyosin molecule is covering the binding site on actin molecules. So myosin is not able to bind to actin. Now the calcium that has just come binds with its friend troponin. This binding causes conformational changes that displaces the tropomyosin into the groove in between two strands of actin molecules. Myosin binding site on actin molecules is now uncovered. This allows myosin to bind here and continue the cross-bridge cycle. This brings us to the myosin cross-bridge cycle. Basically, it is this type of repetitive movement of myosin head that pulls the thin filaments. Let's see what happens exactly in detail. We will start with the state of myosin head just before binding to the actin. It is in line with the arm. And at this point, it is bound to ADP and a phosphate molecule. This head always wants to bind with the actin, but thus far, the binding was prevented by tropomyosin, which was covering the binding site. But now, as the site is exposed, the head can bind with the actin. This triggers a power stroke where the head bends and pulls the thin filament over the thick filament towards the center of the sarcomere. Phosphate is released during the power stroke and ADP is released right after it. The new ATP molecule binds with the head. This binding reduces the affinity of myosin for actin, so it detaches from the actin. Then the ATP is split by myosin ATPase activity into phosphate and ADP. The released energy is used to bend the head back into the initial state. Now it binds with another actin molecule and the entire cycle is repeated. This continues to occur till the site on actin is uncovered. The other head of the same myosin 2 molecule, as well as all the other myosin molecules, do the same thing. In this way, thin filaments are pulled over thick filaments. The same thing happens at the opposite end also. Thus, the pulling shortens the sarcomere. A similar shortening of all the sarcomeres reduces the length of muscle fiber and thereby the muscle. And this produces muscle contraction. Now, few points regarding the length of different bands. See, the A band is the region of thick filaments and I band is region of thin filaments without overlapping thick filaments. As the thin filaments are pulled further and further towards the center, the I band shortens. A band, on the other hand, maintains the same length. So this is how muscle contracts. The process of contraction is terminated by reducing cytoplasmic calcium concentration. On the plasma membrane, we have sodium calcium exchanger and plasma membrane calcium ATPase that pumps calcium out of the myofibril into the extracellular fluid. And on the membrane of cytoplasmic reticulum, we have sarcoplasmic and endoplasmic reticulum calcium ATPase that pumps calcium back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Both of these exits reduce cytosolic calcium concentration. So calcium dissociates from its friend troponin. This moves the tropomyosin back to the resting position where they cover active sites on the actin molecules. So now the myosin head cannot bind with the actin and the process stops. If ATPs are available, the head takes this position. It is a cocked position in which the head is ready to bind with the actin and pull it as soon as the binding site is exposed next time. It is like cocking a gun to make it ready to fire. So this was all about the physiology of muscle contraction. Let's have a quick summary. From now, the signal is transmitted to the muscle fiber at neuromuscular junction. The action potential spreads along the entire surface of the membrane. It penetrates deeper into the cell through T-tubules. T-tubules have L-type of calcium channels that open in response to this action potential. Their opening physically opens calcium release channels also. Through both these channels, the calcium enters into the sarcoplasm. Then it binds with troponin. It moves the tropomyosin away from the binding site for myosin. So now the myosin head binds and pulls the actin towards the center of the sarcomere. The cross-bridge cycle keeps repeating as long as calcium concentration stays high and binding site on actin is exposed. Eventually, calcium is released from troponin and the cycle stops. Sodium calcium exchanger and calcium pump on T-tubules and SERCA on sarcoplasmic reticulum moves calcium out of the cytoplasm. This decreases cytosolic concentration which in fact is the reason for release of calcium from troponin in first place. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.